Entrepreneurs are about to learn that if you want to make a fortune in the world of food, you need more than just a good idea.
The competition's on now, baby.
Just one will win the chance to put their own recipe on the supermarket shelves of Britain.
Breaking into Tesco starts 9 o'clock Monday on 5.
Hello again, welcome back. A reminder of our top story. Prince Harry is to return to the UK after spending 10 weeks fighting on the front line in Afghanistan. Now, earlier this week, we reported on the orphanages in Ukraine where children with HIV are segregated and prevented from playing with the others. Well, the practice has been condemned by charities who are now trying to change attitudes. Five's Victoria Gatenby reports on a new scheme to help HIV-positive mums and their babies stay together.
Abandoned by their HIV-positive mothers, these orphans are stigmatised in the closest thing they have to a home. This orphanage in Ukraine separates the healthy children from those with HIV. Such is the stigma surrounding this virus, young mothers often feel they have no choice but to abandon their children. No one has been willing to help them stay together until now.
At this mother and baby unit, there's room for seven mums and their babies at any one time. They all get a separate bedroom like this, and they can also use the communal kitchen facilities, which are over here. It's all completely free, and up until a couple of years ago, it was a completely unique concept in Ukraine.
Originally, the local government wanted HIV-positive mothers banned. The charity supporting this project refused, and now it's ready to accept anyone who needs help.
We spent over the 1 year and a half working with the local authority of Chernigov administration, working with the staff of center, trained them, support them, you know, showing that it's, you know, the HIV status, it particularly need a special support. They shouldn't be discriminated. If the particular children mixed, I mean the HIV positive and the, if you like, normal children, and they play together, they work together, they benefit.
In the next few months, this centre is hoping to welcome its first HIV positive mother. Yulia, who's 17, says for her, it's been a lifeline.
I can't imagine living without my baby. I carried him here close to my heart for 9 months. Unlike my parents, I would find a way to keep him. Otherwise, it would be barbaric.
Until now, HIV-positive mothers have been forced to live in the shadows. This centre will provide them with the prospect of a brighter future. Victoria Gatenby, 5 News, Ukraine.
David Beckham has admitted he's not yet fit enough to be picked for England. He's been in South Korea as part of a promotional tour with his side, LA Galaxy. Tomorrow he'll play his first game since last November. England play France at the end of next month. Well, the world's biggest airport terminal has been opened in China, ready for this summer's Olympics. The building in Beijing was designed by British architects. It's so large, you could fit all of Heathrow's 5 terminals inside. And with the Olympics just months away, we're following the fortunes of 5 talented young athletes hoping to bring home a medal from Beijing. Today we catch up with the pole vaulter Steve Lewis as he pursues his Olympic dreams.
Steve Lewis is the 2006 Commonwealth Games bronze medalist who's been tipped for the top. Last week we told you how the 21-year-old from Stoke-on-Trent has put his studies on hold to win a medal in Beijing. 11 days after this training session in January, Steve set a new personal best of 5 metres 70, the qualifying mark for the World Indoor Championships. That was a week before the Norwich Union trials in Sheffield.
It's the first time I've been in this position, not chasing standards, just being able now to really focus on what I'm trying to do, trying to jump high, going to try out some new poles today.
We were allowed behind the scenes to film Steve's preparations.
So now we're about 2 hours before competition starts, so I'm going to start running in a minute. I'll be doing a really easy warm-up, getting my body ready. And then we'll have call room, where they check out our spikes, our clothes, make sure we've got all the right kit and numbers. And then they'll take us out onto the track. I'm so excited.
Steve won the trials with a clearance of 5 metres 61.
It's important to me that I keep jumping above 60 now. You know, if I can keep jumping above 60, I can keep shooting for 75 and 80. And that's where the big heights are.
Next week, Steve will face the world's best in Valencia, and we'll catch up with him later in the year. Alex Thomas, 5 News.
And you can find out more about Steve and the rest of the athletes that we're following on the Olympics on our website, 5.tv/news. And if just watching all that running around has made you feel a little tired, then a trip to the cinema may be just the thing. Here's an essential guide to the films hitting the screens this weekend. And our film critic, Mark Eccleston, is with us in the studio. Right, we're going to kick off this evening, aren't we, with Uma Thurman. What can you tell us about what she's been up to?
Her film is called The Accidental Husband, and she's the producer, so she can star in it as well, even though she's not very good at comedy. I mean, she's a good actress, but she shouldn't be in romantic comedies. Anyway, that was the review. Let's describe the movie. She plays someone who's about to marry Colin Firth, who's a bit stiff and, you know, English, so not very suitable. But then she finds out that she's married to someone else, an earthy fireman who's much more fun, called Jeffrey Dean Morgan. So she's trying to extract herself from this incredible situation, basically. I'll show you a clip, which is almost too complicated to explain. Let's just say there's been some misunderstandings.
Okay.
Excuse me, Mr. Bonnenbecker, my name's... Oh, Jesus, Emma, what the hell are you...
Hand noggies. We give each other these little hand noggies. This is my brother, Carl.
Your name is Carl as well? This is a small world.
Yes, teeny, like a gimlet. Yes, my tiny, teeny little brother, but not small. No, big, older, but not by much. Carl, who I love so very, very much.
How's it going, bro?
Funny?
Sophia! No.
No? Okay.
I mean, it's quite predictable, as romantic comedies are, but it's just amazing how clumsily it goes through those rules.
Okay, we're moving on. Nicole Kidman, back to her serious form
On serious dramatic form in something called Margot at the Wedding by a director called Noah Baumbach, who gave us The Squid and the Whale. And he's obviously taking kind of deeply personal and bitter stories about his own parenting and his own upbringing and going, I had a bad time, so you can sit there and pay to watch that.
It's quite gritty, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. It's about two sisters, one of them, Nicole Kidman, the other, Jennifer Jason Leigh, who are a bit estranged, get together because she's going to get married to someone who is a bit of a slob, played by Jack Black. And it looks like they haven't quite buried the hatchet, as I can show you here.
Well, I'm really glad you changed your mind and came. I never heard from you after I sent the invite. I even wondered if you got it.
I'm just so pleased that we're here.
Did you get it?
Yeah. I'm sorry you were so angry.
I wasn't angry. I was disappointed.
Uh-huh, but you see, when you say disappointed, it puts me in a crummy situation, like I let you down.
Well, you did, in a way.
No, I don't see it like that.
Fine, I felt betrayed. Is that word okay?
Again, you're making me the aggressor.
You were the aggressor.
Nicole Kidman, obviously a big star, but Jack Black, I mean, it's his time at the moment, isn't it?
Yeah, in some ways I don't think they know what to do with him. I mean, he was in something called Be Kind, Rewind, a very small indie film. He was in The Holiday as a romantic lead, which doesn't quite work, but I'm very pleased to see him here. He's one of the only likable and interesting characters here, and that's the problem with this film. You know, he's playing angrier and more of a loser than usual, but he's at least watchable.
Okay, we're moving from relationships to a bank heist based on a real-life experience.
Yes, this is great. This is really terrific. It's called The Bank Job. It's based on a true story of a bank robbery in 1971, where the rumour goes that that was organised by the CIA to extract some incriminating photos of Princess Margaret in a saucy clinch in the Caribbean. And Jason Statham plays one of the top bank robbers. I'll show you when they get into the vault, because that is a happy moment for robbers.
Listen, they're on to you.
I'm gathering that this is your top tip for the weekend.
Yeah,
this plays with the truth, though, doesn't it?
Quite seriously. Absolutely. It never mentions Princess Margaret here, because, you know, I don't think it can. And it stretches a bit, and they throw in someone like John Lennon and Mountbatten, but it's good, solid fun.
OK. With my popcorn, I'll be there.
Good.
Mark, thank
Enjoy.
You very much indeed. Have a great weekend to you. Now, reality TV has already blurred the lines between fact and fiction, but the latest publicity stunt for The Sound of Music goes one step further. Summer is the name of an actress who is also a character in Hollyoaks, who's just won the part of Maria. Confused? Five's Asha Tan reports on the tie-up between television and the West End.
The hills fill my heart.
This is Hollyoaks' character Summer auditioning for the part of Maria in The Sound of Music on the soap opera.
To sing every song.
And this is Summer in real life as Maria. Confused? Well, it's part of a clever publicity stunt by Andrew Lloyd Webber. After finding a replacement for Connie Fisher, Lord Lloyd Webber hatched a plan to get a storyline built into the soap opera, where his new starlet Summer plays an aspiring actress who dreams of starring in The Sound of Music. He even got a cameo role for himself too.
Would you like to play Maria in the production that I'm doing at the moment of The Sound of Music?
What was your initial reaction?
Mouth open. I mean, I couldn't comprehend what it was going to be like, because I had, I think it was a week to pack up and go to Liverpool and be in a soap, and to be on television, and I'd never done that before.
In 2006, the reality programme How Do You Solve a Problem Like Maria was used to increase public interest in the winner before the show opened. Connie Fisher was a relatively unknown actress. The power of television exposure proved too good not to be repeated this year.
To laugh like the brook when it trips and falls.
Bringing a storyline to a soap, which then, you know, carries on to real life. I think it's fantastic.
Critics say the theatre has to renew its image to pull in a younger audience.
It's almost something you wouldn't have believed would have happened if you were told about it. But we're in a new climate now where there's this seeming crossover between casting in West End musicals and television entertainment.
I think when they come to the theatre, they want to be familiar with the person who they see on the stage. It's always nicer when you come to the theatre and you know that person.
And you've managed to keep your lovely long tresses.
I have.
No, that was a deal breaker for me. If I had to cut my hair, I wouldn't have done it. So.
She does wear a wig, by the way.
Summer may have left Hollyoaks, but she hopes its fans will be encouraged to come and see her on stage instead. Asha Tanner, 5 News.
Well, that's about it for now. Asha's going to be here at 8 o'clock with a news update. And on 5 News on Monday...
He's offering hope to the country, and I think, and ultimately to the world in a way, because...
Oscar-winning actor to political campaigner Forrest Whitaker tells us why he's backing Barack Obama. Very charming man. That's on Monday at 5. Laura's going to be here with the weather in a moment's time. Have a lovely weekend. Thank you for your company this week. Bye-bye.